Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm going to show you how to add animations to videos, text, and photos in Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and dive right in. I already have a scene here in Adobe Express beta. You see there's an image that I've added here that's basically going to serve as my backdrop to the other content that I'll add here. And you'll see here is my scene. I have stretched it out right here. If you look on the bottom right corner, you can make your scene zoom in or out. I like to have it about 100 so I can see the entire scene, especially when I'm working with very limited scenes. When I have more, that's when I minimize it. So I'm going to go ahead and actually go about 140-ish here. That'll allow me to see everything. And then here is another important setting here is to choose show layer timing. You want to have that turned on so that you can see your layer. So right now I have clicked on the window up here. This is basically my canvas and I can see the project. Now if I click out here, you notice you're not able to see anything in that layer timing adjusted layer section. If I click again, there you see I have selected that. So that's the key. I'm going to show you right here in a bit as we start to add content. So the first thing I'm going to do is add some text here. And I will choose to add text. And I'm just going to call this a Colorado trip. This is from a trip I took recently. And so I'm going to go ahead and customize my text. I have selected the entire text and I have my main library of text that I choose from. I go with the dynamic setting and I'm going to go ahead and adjust the line spacing. And I'm going to go with let's go with a white color. So let's see what happens here. And now I will click on the text here and I can adjust it. We're going to put that right up here, right in this area of the sky. So let's see. I may just do a minor adjustment as far as the colors, maybe add some, when you say shadow. So let's go ahead and do that down here. So here's where we get to the animation setting for the text. So right now, I just want to point out, if you can see here, the text will show during the entire project. So right now, if I move the scrub line, that's what I call this, in the timeline, you can see that the entire word Colorado trip will show during the entire scene, which is 5 seconds, which you see right here in the bottom left corner. So let's go ahead and make some adjustments here. I have added some shadow here and I can customize the shadow by clicking on customize. We go ahead and maybe not make it as blurry. The distance, bring it a little closer, right about there. And I'm going to make color black so that way I can see it. So I've got that set up. So now let's go add some animation to that text. So we're going to go back. Again, here's the important thing. I'll click out here. You notice there's nothing showing in the layer timing section here. But when I click on the text, then it shows Colorado trip. Look what happens when I click on the image. That's the important thing. So you want to make sure that you do select the correct thing. So here, Colorado trip is going to show during the entire scene. We're going to change that here in a bit. First, I'll choose animation here. And you have different types of animations. You have in, which is how your text will animate as it goes into the scene. So you have all these different ones. I'm not going to show you each single one, but I do have some favorites. I do like the bungee and also like the grow. So I'm going to go ahead and choose grow. And when you select grow, you can adjust how long that animation, or I should say, how long does it take to grow in? So I'm going to go ahead and just type in 1 second. And then your personality, you can have it strong, energetic. So I'll hover over so you can see what it looks like. There's loud, very subtle differences. I'm just going to leave it at soft there. And then you have out. So whenever I use animation on text, I like having the same one. That's just my preference. So I'm going to go ahead and click here. So now because I've added animation, now this scene basically becomes a video format. So I'll click play and there's the Colorado trip. And again, it's during the entire scene and then it should grow out. So again, that is depending on what you want to choose. Let me adjust the out here. And so it's going to show during the entirety of the scene. I'm going to make an adjustment here. I'm going to actually shorten that, or I should say not shorten, but make it come in at about the 3 second mark. So if I hit play and there's Colorado trip, and then it goes away. So now let's go ahead and bring the scrubber all the way to the front. And again, remember, there's not going to be anything showing up. Now here's a really neat thing that you can do with these layers. So notice right now there's no text visible, but there is that blue square, and that's because I have this selected. I can actually choose to adjust when it shows up. So now it's going to be at the beginning and then kind of go away towards the middle here, but I'm going to bring this back because I do want it to be about here when it appears and disappears. Now the looping option is how the text will act in between the in and out. You can choose this without an in and out. So the text will basically just loop. So it has a certain type of behavior. So like that one right there, I think it's breathing. So it's kind of jumping in and out. There's a yo-yo option. So again, this just is preference. I'm going to leave it with no looping. So it's just going to go in and out. So now let's go ahead and add a video file or a video on top of this. So this is a really neat thing about the all-in-one editor in Adobe Express Beta is you can add additional content. So let's go ahead and go to media and let's click back here. So you got photos, video, and audio. I'm going to go ahead and add a photo. So you can either upload from device or you can drag it in. I'm going to go ahead and just upload from device. And let's go ahead and go to my folder here. Let's go ahead and find this. I've got some images here. And just for the sake of demo, let's go ahead and choose so many great ones. I'm going to go ahead and go with that one right there. And I'll click open. As you can see, I shot these in that vertical format. And so if I leave it there, just as I mentioned earlier, it is here, it is right here. So if I move the slider, you're gonna see Colorado shows up. So that's kind of in the way there. So what I'll do is slide that here and I'm gonna adjust this probably about down here. Probably not the best photo because it's kind of blue on blue, but that's fine. And here's a trick. Is I'm going to choose to crop that just so it's a bit out of the way and make it go with a circle format here. And we'll put that down here. Again, it's probably not my best example here. I would have chosen a different photo, but for now, we're going to leave that the way it is. Now, if I hit play, you know, the picture just kind of sitting there. So we want to add some animation to that picture as well. So here's what I'll do with the picture selected. Again, here's the important thing about having this show layer selected turned on is as you slide through, you can see all your content and you want to make sure that you select the correct one. I don't want to animate this again. I do want to click on this photo that I just brought in and here we go, animation. Actually, here's what I'll do just so you can tell a big difference. I'm going to go to adjustment, actually wrong one. Let's go to effects and we're just add an effect to that image. Let's make that, let's just go drastic. Let's see, tint it, colorize it. Let's see here. Let's go with that one just so you can see a contrast there. Try not the best option. That's, again, I'm just very critical of myself here, but here we go. We got animation now. Let's click on animation. And now what we're going to do is we're going to have that photo right here come in, or I should say animate in and out. Or maybe in this case, I'll go ahead and loop that one. So let's go ahead and loop it. And I think for this one, let's see what happens. We bob it in and out. That's pretty cool. I'll choose to bob it. And what we're going to do is when this Colorado trip pops up, I do want the photo, this one right here, to appear. So let's go ahead and slide that here. So that way when it Colorado trip and then that pops in. And it's very drastic there. So I'm actually going to do one more thing. Let's animate this in. We're going to go with a fade and then we're going to fade it out. Again, that's just my preference. I like that fading in and out. So here we go. So we hit play, text comes in, animate that. And then now there's that's bombing in and out. Now that went super fast. So let's go ahead and click here and it's 1 second for, let's go 0.5 and let's go with 0.5. Let's see if that works. And let's hit play. And then the text animates in and then there we go. It fades out. So really neat. And now we're going to do one last thing is we're going to add a photo. I'm sorry, not a photo, but a video. So what I'm going to do here is actually stretch this scene. So right now it's 5 seconds. We're going to stretch this scene out to, let's go about 10 seconds. That's a nice thing, is that you can make this last longer. And here we go, about 10 seconds right there. And what will happen, this is actually has stretched out, if you can see. I don't want that to show that entire time. I'm going to actually make this disappear, I should say fade out about there. And I'm going to make an adjustment to Colorado Trip. We're going to actually drag that one further out. Actually, let's just take it all the way to the end. So you can easily make edits on the fly. We got Colorado Trip that's coming in, and right about here is where I want the video to appear now. So let's go back to media, and we're going to go to video option here, and we're going to upload a video that I shot here, and I've got this one ready to go. And let's bring that video in. So here we have the video that's going to be superimposed on top of a photo. So it takes a little bit of time for those videos to show up. I'm going to go ahead and wait for that media to finish uploading, and then we'll continue. Now that my video has finished uploading here, I'm going to go ahead and trim and add some animation to that. So let's go ahead. First off, we're going to slide this over here. There you can see the animated photo behind it, and it disappears. And we're going to make this video here appear and disappear. So first off, I'm going to drag that over here. So I think this is probably where I want it to appear after that fade out there. And then this comes in. So let's go ahead and crop this. So we'll go crop. And I'm going to go ahead and go with, I'm going to keep that theme with the circle here, make it a little bit bigger. And then we're going to click. And let's go ahead one more time to crop. If this happens to you, this is what you do. Move it a bit like that, and then you can adjust it. And then we're going to make sure that the entire video fills in that area. And here is what we'll do. Let's click out. We got that. Now, here's a really important thing when you're working with video is you see this area here. It is, I would say, faded out a bit. That's what's visible in the scene. So right now, only what's inside this section will be visible. And here's a cool thing is that you can slide it, because actually this video, I planned this out. I think I ride in about here, and then I kind of get excited and start jumping. There we go. So let's see here. I think I'll put it about right there, and let's see what it looks like. I'll be riding here. Let's make it come in a little more. So let's see here. This happens, then that slides in. Let's add some animation to that. We're going to have this fade in, and then we're going to have it fade out. And so we're going to scrub through. There it comes. I'm walking up to the mountain that I see, and then boom. Let's go ahead and hit play. We have the text that will fade in, and then we have the image, and then it's bouncing up, and then the video comes in with me walking, and then everything kind of fades out about the same time, and there we go. And now what's left to do is for me to download this project. I'll click download, and I can choose whatever resolution I want, and then choose to download. Right now, again, it is set up to download as a video. You can also download as a static project if you want a PNG. You just want to make sure and select the right spot where you want that to show up, and then you are ready to go. And that's how you can add animations to text, photos, and videos in Adobe Express. If you have any comments or questions about this video, feel free to drop it into the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with friends so that YouTube shares it with a wider audience. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. Have fun creating, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.